Tacoma production slashed. This is why you can't find a new Toyota Tacoma. Well, good morning, everybody. How are you today? Pretty good here, and that's right. Toyota is slashing production on the Toyota Tacoma. Now, this is why you can't find one right now. You know, recently a subscriber to the channel, Scott, sent me a little clip, I guess, a little news story about what's going on. You see, he has a Tacoma on order, a Voodoo Blue Tacoma, I believe, and was just notified that production of his brand new shiny Tacoma has been delayed. So he did a little bit of research, and to be honest, I was aware of this myself. I had seen a story maybe a month ago or so about this, and I thought, well, things are starting to return back to normal. And you know, it's because of the current world situation that this is going on right now. But things are kind of returning back to normal, you know, sort of. And I figured maybe it would subside a little bit. But apparently, given Scott's recent conundrum or issues with trying to put his hands on a new Tacoma, it doesn't seem to be so. So what is going on? Why is Toyota slashing production? It's not just Toyota, by the way. It's due to this semiconductor shortage, at least more so for the other suppliers. Again, it's due to the current world situation, right? Now, let's talk a little bit about Ford and GM because they've been hit a little bit harder. Ford projects that they're going to lose $2.5 billion in earnings due to this, and it could go higher. GM is going to lose $2 billion. That's a lot of zeros, right? Now, why is Toyota not affected quite so much by this? They are affected by something else. We'll get to that in a minute. And don't get me wrong, this is affecting them as well. But Toyota has a better long-range planning model. So they project a little bit better and they order things and get them in or coming, or at least get their name on them, a little bit better than Ford and GM. And that's not surprising to me. You know, Toyota's a little bit more detailed, it seems. You can see that in their quality and reliability, right? Now, they are cutting shifts and production lines to deal with this because they can't get other things that they need. What am I talking about there? Petrochemical shortages are affecting Toyota even more so. They can't get the chemicals and things that they need to produce the parts to build these trucks. Now, they say that they're going to be slashing production in Kentucky and Mexico, as well as an engine plant in Alabama. You know, I had thought, I guess early on when this whole world situation started, that the reason we weren't seeing new trucks in the factories and things, or in dealerships rather, is because they had shut down the factories, right? You know, when everything was at its peak, hopefully we're on the downside of this now, but when everything was at its peak, they shut down factories. I think for as long as maybe a month or so, some of their plants, and that just kind of set everything back. But thinking even broader than that, right? They weren't the only ones shutting down. There were other manufacturers and plants shutting down as well, particularly, again, these semiconductor manufacturers, as well as the petrochemical industry. Now, one thing that I saw that was kind of interesting to me, and it figures, is what GM is doing. You know, GM has decided to leave out some of these fuel management modules. I guess they're the things that are heavy semiconductor users, I guess. But they're going to leave them out of their trucks, right? Now, that means they're going to burn more fuel, so that already horrid fuel economy rating is going to go down. It'll be interesting to see if they note that. There should be a caveat or something on their stickers, I would think, to show that reduction in fuel economy, because they're going to leave off the fuel management module. It's also going to increase emissions. I wonder if they'll be able to sell their trucks in California. You know, California, that's so strict about everything. What's going to happen there? My guess is they're probably going to have to pay some sort of a fine or a fee, because there's no way they're going to completely shut them down, California that is. But they're going to make them pay for it. And this is a perfect excuse to do it, right? If you don't meet our emission standards, we're going to get you for it. And I'm sure that's what's going to happen with GM. Ford, I haven't seen anything about them cutting things out. But you got to think that if GM is doing it, Ford's probably going to do it too. Now, the other thing that is interesting in this to me, as I mentioned, this is the reason why you can't get new Tacomas right now, because they're not making them. You can't make them if you don't have the parts, right? Or the chemicals that are needed to manufacture the parts. But what about this Tundra that's coming up? You know, this is horrible timing for Toyota, right? They have been messing with this redesigned Tundra, I think, for probably the last 2, maybe 3 years. And it was finally rumored recently, I don't know that it was so much as a rumor, maybe more fact, that this truck was going to come out in December, right? I think it was announced that it would be a December release as a 2022 model. But I don't see that happening now. I mean, if they can't get the parts to manufacture the trucks, how can they build inventory to go ahead and have a major release? And this is a major release for Toyota, right? I mean, they're redesigning the Tundra. I wouldn't say it's their bread and butter vehicle. You know, that's the Tacoma back here. And I could certainly see Toyota kind of slowing down the release of the Tundra so that they can utilize these semiconductor parts in their bread and butter vehicle, the Tacoma back here. We shall see. So what do you do if you're looking for a new Tacoma? They are out there. I mean, they're trickling in at a slow pace. You know, Scott, I mentioned him in the beginning, he has his truck on order, and he asked me this morning, you know, hey, how do I do a search in across the nation to try to find my truck? Well, there are two avenues to do this. I've done it myself before, and that is Cars.com and Auto Trader. And no, I'm not sponsored by either one of those. They're just excellent resources to be able to search the nation. All you have to do is go out there, plug in what you're looking for, filter it with new car dealers only, and the Toyota Tacoma, of course, the model that you're looking for. That's all you have to do, and it will pop up for any of the businesses out there that actually subscribe or advertise on these two websites, obviously. But it's a very handy tool. And you know, it's interesting because I tried to do this, and I don't know if it's changed, but I tried to do this a while back when I was looking for my truck before I ordered. And I went to Toyota's site. And I would have thought you could have put in the information, you know, that you were looking for and done a nationwide search. But they don't do that. They limit it to a small area within your home address or within whatever zip code you want to input. Now, you could sit down with, I don't know, a million different zip codes, start inputting them and see if any of the dealers that pop up happen to have the truck you want. But you better have days, maybe weeks to do that, because it would become very, very time consuming. Anyway, I just wanted to get on here, kind of talk about that a little bit. I've seen some frustration out there on the web. People looking for trucks, they can't find them. Some are even settling for lesser vehicles than what they wanted, so that they can at least get into some sort of a Tacoma. Leave a comment, let me know. If you've been looking for a Tacoma, have you had trouble finding one? The one that you wanted. I'd be curious to know. Also, real quick, if you're interested, I have two other channels. The first is Rob Motive JT, all about my 2020 Jeep Gladiator out here. And the second is Rob Motive Civic, all about my experiences with the Honda Civic Type R and the Honda Civic Hatchback. Check them out. If you're interested, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye. There were other businesses, other plants and manufacturing shops. Magic book.